One of the most surprising things that we've experienced in the last 10 years in biology is the huge complexity of the system. It's not only about the molecules, it's about the interconnections between these molecules that make the function of the cell. The main property of a complex system is what is known as emergent properties, and this is understood by the sentence that the whole is more than the sum of its parts. So we're not trying to understand the genes or the proteins, but also how everything is interconnected. And that's exactly the aim of network biology, to study the system as a whole. We build in silico models of living systems that afterwards allow us to identify key properties that are not trivial from the individual elements. And afterwards, we go to the laboratory and validate these new properties experimentally. Alzheimer's disease is a paradigm of a complex pathology. Currently, we have no drugs to modify the biology of the disease. What we've done in the lab is to identify more than 300 interactions around this pathology. We took them to the computer, we built dynamic models for the disease progression, and now we are taking a network medicine approach to fight the disease simultaneously from different fronts and to stop the advance. Breast cancer is another complex disease, but unlike Alzheimer, in this case, we have many drugs approved to fight it. The problem here is the appearance of resistance. And in many cases, this resistance is because of the crosstalk between different networks or between pathways. Our network medicine strategy here is to identify the best points to target in these networks to avoid this cross-reactivity and therefore to prevent relapse. My personal dream is to find a cure for Alzheimer's disease. It's obvious that current pharmacological approaches to tackle complex diseases just don't work. We need to take the risk with novel strategies. We need fresh ideas. Our fresh idea is to implement network medicine. As a personal object, I brought these tools. I work as an electrician with my father for over 10 years, and that's not that different to what we do in the lab. You walk into an old house that has no power. Obviously, the house is wired, but you have no idea where are the cables or which ones are the connections. So what you have to do is to isolate the different subnetworks or circuits until you identify the problem and can solve the shortcut. And this is what we do with cells in the lab.